Our heart rejoices in him.
For his holy name, we are
Let your loving kindness, O Lord, be upon us. Second reading is a reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Now faith is the assurance of things hoped for, the convictions of things not seen. Indeed, by faith our ancestors received approval. By faith, we understand that the worlds were prepared by the word of God, so that what is seen was made from things that are not visible. By faith, Abraham obeyed when he was called to set out for a place that he was to receive as an inheritance. And he set out, not knowing where he was going. By faith, he stayed for a time in the land he had been promised, as in a foreign land, living in tents, as did Isaac and Jacob, who were heirs with him of the same promise. For he looked forward to the city that has foundations, whose architect and builder is God. By faith, he received power of procreation, even though he was too old. And Sarah herself was barren, because he considered him faithful who had promised. Therefore, from one person, and this one as good as dead, descendants were born, as many as the stars of heaven, and as the innumerable grains of sand by the seashore. All of these died in faith without having received the promises, but from a distance they saw and greeted them. They confessed that they were strangers and foreigners on the earth. For people who speak in this way make it clear that they are seeking a homeland. If they had been thinking of the land that they had left behind, they would have had opportunity to return. But as it is, they desire a better country, that is, a heavenly one. Therefore, God is not ashamed to be called their God. Indeed, he has prepared a city for them. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please be seated.
So last week, we heard the story of the rich man who had filled his existing barn with harvest, and having still more, decided to tear that barn down and build a bigger one to hold all that God had given him. The rich man's original barn had held plenty for seasons past. He is called the rich man, after all, not the man who was barely getting by and then God blessed him. So before we get into today's gospel, there are 10 verses that the lectionary has us skip over between the story of the rich man and today's reading. After telling his disciples the story of the rich man and how it is with those who store up treasures for themselves but are not rich toward God, Jesus continues, "Therefore I tell you, do not worry about your life, what you will eat, or about your body, what you will wear. For life is more than food, and the body more than clothing. Consider the ravens. They neither sow nor reap. They have neither storehouse nor barn, and yet God feeds them. Of how much more value are you than the birds? Can any of you, by worrying, add a single hour to your span of life? If you're not able to do so small a thing as that, why do you worry about the rest? Consider the lilies, how they grow. They neither toil nor spin, yet I tell you, even Solomon in all his glory was not clothed like one of these. But if God so clothes the grass of the field, which is alive today and tomorrow is thrown into the oven, how much more will he clothe you, you of little faith? Do not keep striving for what you are to eat and what you are to drink. Do not keep worrying. It is the nations of the world that strive after all these things. God knows that you need them. So instead, strive for God's kingdom, and these things will be given to you as well. So sell your possessions and give alms. Make purses for yourselves that do not wear out, an unfailing treasure in heaven." Notice that Jesus doesn't say, sell all your possessions. I mean, he does say that later in Luke's gospel, when the rich ruler asks him what he must do to inherit eternal life. But that's not what he's saying here. What Jesus is getting at here, again, is he imploring his followers to draw closer to one another and to release our grasp on that which ties us down to the kingdom of empire, instead of finding true freedom in the kingdom of God. The selling that Jesus is speaking of here is a bartering, more than an act of first world charity, helping those less fortunate than ourselves and receiving accolades for our generosity upon our return home. Bartering ties us to one another. It's an economy of connection rather than an economy of transaction. Based on this understanding of selling Jesus is speaking of, almsgiving must also be understood in a way of establishing and maintaining connection, rather than the blind transaction of leaving money in an alms box. The Greek word, which is translated here as alms, means first, pity. Barter your possessions and give pity, Jesus says. And to our modern ears, that probably rings a little strange. Pity is a word that creates or underscores separation between people in the way that we often use it. There, but for the grace of God, go I, we say. But what we are really saying is we are glad that we, in fact, are not you. Why? Well, because I eat better, or make better financial decisions, or exercise more, or the list can go on and on and on, and with each item, a wall is built between us. In Greek, this word pity means that we are linked at the gut. We feel one another's pain and know one another's distress when we are properly human, as God calls us to be. Therefore, Jesus' directive to give alms has a much broader, more inclusive implication than simply giving money to meet financial needs. This is about allowing ourselves to be tied to one another at the gut, to allow ourselves to feel another's pain and worry, and deep joy and celebration. When we as a community concern ourselves more with the well-being of our neighbor than our image or position in society as individuals, we are entering the kingdom of God. The material things of this world can be taken away, burned, or stolen. But the relationships we build with one another, those which are true, through which God will always provide for our needs, are eternal and cannot be plundered by the powers of this world. I ask you to join me in prayer. God, our thief, steal from us our dead, complacent hearts, and kindle in us a new flame. Take from our hands the burden of worthless things, and make them ready to receive a greater gift, the love of a servant king, through Jesus Christ, the Son of Man. Amen. Standing as you're able, let us affirm our faith in the words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God,
Father the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism of the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Prayers of the people. Father, we pray for your holy Catholic Church.
That we are only one.
Grant that every member of the Church may truly and humbly serve you.
That your name be glorified by all people.
We pray for all bishops, priests, and deacons.
That they be faithful ministers of your word and sacraments.
We pray for all who govern and hold authority in the nations of the world.
That there may be justice and peace on the earth.
Give us grace to do your will in all that we undertake.
That our works may find favor in your sight.
Have compassion on those who suffer from any grief or trouble.
That they may be delivered from their distress.
Give to the departed eternal rest.
That the light of perpetual shine on them.
We praise you for your saints who have entered into joy.
May we also come to share in their heavenly kingdom.
Let us pray for our own needs and those of others.
God, we ask that you hear the prayers spoken aloud today and those that remain in our heart. Send your comfort to those who need it. Send endurance to those who require it. And help us all to grow more and more into an image of you. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God,
we confess our sins against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you.
Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
I invite you to greet one another in a sign of Christ's peace.
Good morning, everybody. I have some announcements. In the bulletin, we are searching for a vendor, and you should have received an email this week asking for two more questions. If you have not answered those questions, please look in the bulletin to find out what the website is so that you can. The food pantry would like more soap. And lastly, the Trading Post is having a summer clearance, so you can get 50% off all of your wonderful clothes. And Mr. Morrison has something to say today.
Consisting of Carol and Fred Green, Sandy and Frank Esmond, Steve and Fran Pine, Louise D'Onofrio, Miss D'Onofrio, and yours truly. Our goal is to celebrate and have a wonderful affair for family, friends, community, youth, elderly, it doesn't matter. We want to fill the church and have a good time. We plan to have a picnic brunch immediately after what's going to be the 9:30 service. We'll be going back to the 9:30 service on that Sunday. 10:30 on, we're going to celebrate Welcome Back. We're hopeful to have a food truck, ice cream truck, games, entertainment, possibly a magician. All of this will be no cost to parishioners, family, friends, etc. There'll be a free raffle consisting of prizes. As you enter and you get to sign up and come into the church or come up to our patio, you'll be given a ticket. That's a chance to win one of the many prizes we're going to have. Just to give you an idea, $50 gift certificate to Stop and Shop, $50 gift certificate to Olive Garden, a gas card to Cumberland Farms of $50, $50 Longhaul Steakhouse, and finally, with more than likely be a cash prize of $100. All of this is free to everybody that comes. Obviously, you have to have a winning ticket. We're also opening this up to the community. If you have a friend that you know might like to come, say hi to St. Mark's, have a little tour, see what we're all about, they're certainly welcome. It's not just the St. Mark's portion. September 11th, Welcome Back, celebration. Write it down. Don't forget. Thank you.
Hi, everybody. I just want everyone to join me in welcoming Warren back as our supply, bridge priest. Thank you. I'm sorry, I didn't get it. On August 21st, We want to have a parish meeting. We plan to discuss things that are going on with our clergy search, but also some collaboration opportunities, because we have some decisions that need to be made, so we hope everyone will make an effort to be here. Again, that's August 21st at the 10 o'clock coffee and conversation before the service on August 21st. Thank you.
Are there any other announcements for the good of the order? Walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us, an offering and sacrifice to God. love you made us for yourself. And when we had fallen into sin and become subject to evil and death, you, in your mercy, sent Jesus Christ, your only and eternal Son, to share our human nature, to live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to you, the God and Maker of all. Jesus stretched out his arms upon the cross and offered himself, in obedience to your will, a perfect sacrifice for the whole world. On the night he was handed over to suffering and death, our Savior Jesus Christ took bread, and when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, Jesus took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ is God. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
We celebrate the memorial of our redemption, Almighty God, in this sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Recalling Christ's death, resurrection, and ascension, we offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit to be for your people the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life in Christ. Sanctify us also, that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. And at the last day, bring us with all your saints into the joy of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask through Jesus Christ, our Savior. By Christ, and with Christ, and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty God, now and forever.
Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say,
"Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, power, and glory, forever and ever. Amen."
Alleluia, Christ our Passover is sacrificed for us.
Therefore let us keep peace. Alleluia.
Thank you.
Together, let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, we thank you for feeding us with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and for assuring us in these holy mysteries that we are living members of the body of Christ and heirs of your eternal kingdom. And now send us out to do the work you have given us to do, to love and serve you as faithful witnesses of Christ, our Savior. To him, to you, and to the Holy Spirit, be honor and glory, now and forever. Amen.
Life is short, and we do not have too much time to gladden the hearts of those who journey with us. So be swift to love, make haste to be kind, and the blessing of God, the Creator, the Redeemer, and the Sustainer be with you this day and always.